Today, I will discuss the following topics. First one. How the discretization of integrator is performed. Second one. What is bilinear transformation, and how it is used. Then I will explain how to write the code for PI controller implementation using C programming language. And finally, the demonstration of everything you learned using psim simulation. In order to implement PI controller in digital system, we need to convert all the terms to sampling domain. I will start with writing PI controller transfer function. Transfer function is given by output y of s equals to e of s into kp plus ki divided by s. In time domain, we can express this equation as y of t is equal to e of t into kp plus ki into integral of e of t dt. Now we need to convert both these terms to sampling domain. Proportional term can be converted easily. And it is given by e of n into kp. In order to convert the integral term, we need more explanation. So, now I will explain how we can convert integral terms to sampling domain. We know that integration is nothing but area under the curve. Now I will take a random error signal. Consider a small strip under this curve, where e of n is the current error, and e of n minus 1 is the previous error. Ts is the width of the strip, which is actually the sampling time. This strip can be considered as a square, and there are three methods to find its area. First method is forward Euler. In this method, area is given by Ts into e of n minus 1. By adding area of all small strips like this, we will get the total integral value. So the integral value can be written as integral is equal to integral plus Ts into e of n minus 1. Second method is backward Euler, where integral is given by following equations. Third method is trapezoidal rule. Here integral term is given by following equations. I am using this method in my demonstration using psim simulation. Another method to discretize PI controller is by using bilinear transformation. Using bilinear transformation, we can convert S domain transfer function to Z domain transfer function. To do that, we replace S by 2 by T into Z minus 1 divided by Z plus 1. Now let me write the integrator transfer function, which is given by Y of S is equal to E of S into KI divided by S. Now replace S by 2 by T into Z minus 1 divided by Z plus 1. So we will get Z domain equation as Y of Z is equal to E of Z into KI into T by 2 into Z plus 1 divided by Z minus 1. Z plus 1 divided by Z minus 1 can be written as 1 plus Z inverse divided by 1 minus Z inverse. On substitution, we will get the following equation. On cross multiplication, we will get y of z into 1 minus z inverse is equal to e of z into ki into t by 2 into 1 plus z inverse. Convert this z domain equation into sampling domain equation, we will get the following. Y of n is equal to y of n minus 1 plus ki into t by 2 into e of n plus e of n minus 1. This equation is same as what we got using trapezoidal rule. So this concludes the discretization of PI controller. Now I will demonstrate everything using psim simulation tool. Let me rewind what we have done in the last lecture. We have connected a 12 volt DC at the input, then we have filter, inductor and capacitor. We have a 50 ohm load connected at the output. Finally we have PI controller blocks and PWM block. Before proceeding further, I will just run the simulation and show some results. This is the output for 5 volt reference voltage. Now let me change the reference to 9. Run the simulation again. We are getting 9 volt at the output. So this much we had done in the last class. Now I will show how to write PI controller using C. I am going to replace all these blocks using a single C block. First I will delete all these. Now choose a C block from the list. Connect input to the sensor output and output to the input of comparator block. Now open the C block. We have only one input, that is actual voltage, and one output, that is the PI controller output. First, I will define KP and KI values. For time being, keep KI value as 0. Now I will declare the variables required. I am using double type variables. You can use any type, according to your project. We need 3 variables here. Error. Previous error. An integral term. Give some value to the reference voltage. For time being, I am giving 5. Now define error, which is the difference between reference and actual value. Here, X1 means actual voltage given at input of C block. Now the integral term that we have already explained. I will write the same here. Now define current error as the previous error. Now finally the output, which is given by KP into error plus integral term. Give 0 to 1 as the saturation limit for PI controller. Let me rewind everything once again. First we have defined KP and KI values. Then variable declaration. And finally controller part with output saturation. Now compile the code. It is successful. Now run the simulation. 4-5 volt reference, we are getting the same at the output. We have small steady state error, that we will reduce by adjusting KI value. Now I will change the reference. I will put 10. Here also we can see, a small steady state error. Now I will give 3 as reference. We are getting 3 volt, at the output. Initially we have given KI value as 0, now we change KI and see the difference. I will put a small value, 0.001. Run the simulation. Now see the output voltage. The steady state error has been reduced, drastically. Now give some other reference voltage, and see the steady state error. See, here also steady state error has reduced. Now I will show you, what happens, if we increase the KI value further. Let me make it 0.1. Run the simulation, and see the output. Voltage is oscillatory and it keep increasing. That means, the system is unstable. This way, we can tune the PI controller. So this much for today's class. I will see you soon with some other topics. Thank you.